4 years ago, I was in a car crash with one of my best friends. It was a normal day, we were heading to college, but it wasn't going to be a normal college day. So I was with my friend, and I'm not going to name him in this video just in case he doesn't want to be named. So for the video purposes, I will name him Jimmy. I also apologize for the birds. There's nothing I can do about them, but you know, they're just making a noise. Also, if you think this building looks pretty cool, you can also check out our vlog where we explored this whole area. There's around 6 buildings and we explored every single one of them. Just click that picture there and it'll take you right to the vlog. On the 6th of November 2012, me and Jimmy were in a car crash. On our way to college, we were traveling around 60 or 70 miles an hour. It was a main road and it was just all flowing all the way until we came around a bend. We came around this bend, as I said, around 60 or 70 miles an hour, and around the corner, there was just stopped traffic. We weren't expecting this. Now, let me just give you a little bit of backstory on the car that we were in. This is the car that we were in, a Skoda Felicia from around 1994. So this car was pretty old. The car didn't have any modern safety features, it had no airbags, it had no anti-lock brakes, so pretty much whenever you press the brake, nothing really happened. So we were traveling around 60 or 70 miles an hour, and we seen the cars had stopped, and Jimmy, who was driving the car, I was the passenger, Jimmy was driving, and he slammed on the brakes. Now, unfortunately, as I said, the car was pretty old. The brakes didn't work. We must have slowed down maybe 10 miles an hour, so we were still going around between 50 and 60 miles per hour when we smashed into the back of another car. Now, this car was literally a tin on wheels. Any form of impact with the car just went squish. And that's exactly what happened. We smashed into the back of this car. We could see it coming as well. That was the worst bit. We could see the car getting quicker and closer towards us. And then, bam! We hit the car. I remember when we were approaching the car, I tensed up. Now, I don't know if that's the right thing to do or if that's the wrong thing to do, but either way, I tensed up. It was a natural reaction. Jimmy, on the other hand, was driving, so he was just trying to slam on the brakes. He wasn't really tensing up. In hindsight, I shouldn't have tensed up because it was actually me that got injured the most. So we hit the car in front at around 55 miles per hour. And as you can see from this picture, the whole front of our car just caved in. Now, as I said, I tensed up, so my legs were stretched right out in front of me as far as they could go into the footwell. And as I've just said, the whole front of the car caved in. That means my legs were still in there and they got crushed. This hurt like a... And I remember my phone flew forward into the footwell, and that was my priority. Before myself, I wanted to make sure my phone was okay. That's the world we live in these days. So I remember Jimmy turning to me and saying, "Lee, are you okay? Are you all right?" And he was panicked, understandably. And I just remember being in a hell of a lot of pain because I could not feel my legs. So I opened the door, I threw my phone out, and I tried to get out of the car. But as I said, I couldn't feel my legs, so my legs just gave way. My main objective at that point was to get off the road and get out of the way. And I just remember falling onto the grass outside the car. Luckily, as we crashed, an ambulance was actually driving in the opposite direction. So they pulled over, stopped all the traffic, and everything was okay. I remember sitting on the grass being in a hell of a lot of pain. The ambulance people attended to me, made sure I was okay. I remember Jimmy went and asked the people in front of us, who we hit, if they were okay. And there was actually a few people in the car who got whiplash and back pain and all that sort of stuff from the actual crash. But what we later found out was the car that we hit then hit the car in front of them. So that just shows you how powerful the crash actually was. At this point, I was in a lot of pain. I was also struggling to breathe because the seatbelt in the car jammed because of the impact. So when I bolted forward, my chest was severely crushed by the seatbelt. So I was now sitting on the grass. I couldn't feel my legs. I couldn't breathe properly. So the paramedics got me into the ambulance and they drove me to the hospital. From that point on, I don't really know what happened at the scene of the crash. I just know that the car was actually written off. It was beyond repair. I don't think my mum will ever forget the moment when I got into that ambulance because I texted her to say, "I'm in an ambulance. I've been in a car crash." Now, I'm not a parent myself, but I could understand the worry and the emotions that would go through you when you get a text like that off your son. So the worst part of this was that my mother actually replied to me saying something about, you know, what happened, oh my God, are you okay, that sort of thing, as you would, but my phone died. So now my mum is sitting there, knowing that her son is in an ambulance and has just been in a car crash, but receives no further texts because my phone has run out of battery. Great timing, iPhone. So luckily, she knew which hospital I was going to, and she got in her car and drove there as quick as she could. Funnily enough, she actually beat me to the hospital. So when I was in the ambulance, I was getting loads of needles into my arm, my hands and everything, and I had the face mask on trying to help my breathing and all this sort of stuff, and it was so chaotic, I didn't really know what was going on. And the hospital was around 30 to 40 minutes of driving, and we had the sirens on and everything, and it was the first time I actually been in an ambulance, and it was pretty interesting. So yeah, finally got to the hospital, and they put me in a wheelchair inside the ambulance, and they wheeled me out and into the hospital, and I got a load of checks and everything, and my mum was just sat there in the waiting room, just waiting to hear, you know, is my son okay? Thankfully, I was okay. Over the next sort of 3 or 4 days, I literally couldn't move. I was stuck in bed, I couldn't breathe very well, my legs were hurting, and it was just a horrible experience. I did get a few days off college though, so that was pretty good. Long term though, I actually think Jimmy, my friend, was impacted more than I was. Because although we had the crash, in the middle of my driving lessons, you know, at the time I was learning to drive myself, and I was very worried that it was going to affect my confidence and how I would drive. Luckily, it didn't. Although, for my friend, I feel like it's affected him long term. It's now 4 years later, and I can tell with the way he drives, he's not that confident in driving anymore. As for the people who were in the car in front of us who we hit, we didn't really hear much more about them. We just know that there was some of them that were pretty badly hurt with whiplash and back pain. They all got sorted though, and everything was fine. So luckily, pretty much everybody was all right in the end. And I think that's where I'm going to end it for this video. I hope you've enjoyed it. As I said, if you like this location, then please check out the vlog where we checked out this whole abandoned area. On Mondays and Fridays, there will be vlog videos uploaded. And on Wednesday nights, there will be a video uploaded where I'll discuss various topics, whether it's a story from my past or something I'm currently doing. There'll be something interesting to watch on a Wednesday night as well. So leave a comment if you enjoy this video, leave a like if you enjoy this video, and subscribe for more content like this.